Who would have thought that the AI invasion would look less like this? And more like this.
Hello, and welcome back to another Fails compilation.
AI voices are said to have a profound impact on the creative industries, from video games and education to YouTube videos and advertisements. So we need to take a look at how they're made. Some AI voices are already highly recognizable, like Bev standing for TikTok.
My younger brother, yo sis, yo bro.
Or Susan Bennett as Siri.
Siri, what are the top 10 books of 2017?
Here's what I found on the web for what are the top 10 books of 2017.
But to get an AI voice to have the quality of Siri was difficult. Susan Bennett had to record thousands of lines over many years in a pro studio to capture all the intonations and individual phonemes. Apple's algorithm for Siri then strings these recordings together and concatenates the audio to recreate the realistic sounding speech. Creating Siri was a complex process compared with earlier text-to-speech machines, such as the robotic voice of the Caltex 5010, which was popularized by Stephen Hawking.
But my old system had a rather primitive system for predicting the next word.
And the original 1976 Kurzweil reading machine, which also sounds very inhuman.
I founded Kurzweil Computer Products, Incorporated that year to develop the first OCR program that could recognize any style of print, which we succeeded in doing later that year.
Nowadays, AI voices sound much more realistic thanks to their foundation. AI is structured to mimic the human brain, the most complex biological machine in the known universe, in what's called artificial neural networks. They're the powerhouse of modern AI. The only issue? Sophisticated AI requires an immense amount of data to anticipate and react to user inputs effectively. I won't go into detail how the algorithms, machine learning, and deep learning models work. We'll link to a video in the description should you want an in-depth scientific answer. Instead, let's use cats as an example, because where would the internet be without them? For an AI designed to identify photos of cats, it must be fed pictures of cats and other animals, like dogs, so it can learn the difference. What a cat looks like may seem obvious to us, but an AI is a completely blank slate. It has no point of reference or ability to differentiate between the two animals, so it needs to learn from scratch. The artificial neural network starts by predicting whether a picture is a cat or not. Then its answers are cross-referenced against data, providing the correct answer. The AI with the highest success rate, the one that's best at telling what a cat is, will be used as a template for the AI's deep learning model. The template will continually be refined. Through immense amounts of trial and error, each iteration of the AI system becomes better and better at identifying what a cat looks like compared to a dog, incrementally improving the efficiency, eventually evolving to the point of instantly identifying a cat in busy photos. This process is called backpropagation, and it allows neural networks to learn and improve. The more data fed into the machine, the better the AI becomes at completing its task. The combination of these artificial neural networks, machine learning, and deep learning methods allows the AI to clone you the way you write, look, create, and even sound. Creating artificial voices used to take weeks or even years of recording time. Now, only a few seconds of audio is needed to recreate the sound of your voice. This is achieved in three main stages: vocal breakdown, natural language processing, and speech synthesis. Firstly, the AI analyzes audio data of someone's speech to break down the voice into its core pronunciations. This then requires another side of the AI to use natural language processing to comprehend the way language works. Comprehending language means sifting through immense amounts of audio data to develop a system capable of navigating speech and the way it should sound. Speech synthesis is the final stage, which pulls together the previous two steps to create a cloned voice. Pairing up the voice template from the vocal data and the language processing model to synthesize the speech as an AI voiceover. It has never been so easy to create an AI version of you or someone else. However, there are many dangers with voice cloning technology, which is why tools like Meta's VoiceBox have been held back from the market. We'll be looking at the real dangers of voice cloning that we all face in future videos. So feel free to hit that subscribe button to get notified. Modern AI voices require a combination of algorithms, machine learning, and deep learning to create the system that makes it comprehend a query and respond with an answer, as well as only a few seconds of audio to replicate sound. But AI voices struggle to accurately portray emotions, which means they regularly fail to connect with audiences. If you're a content creator who cares about your global audience, human voices are always better. Using AI voices to dub your channel into other languages may end up doing you more harm than good. This is why Voquent created a range of human dubbing packages for all budgets. Our starter package offers all the essentials at an especially affordable rate, the perfect alternative to AI voices. Do you think AI voices will become as good as the real thing in the future? Let us know in the comments below, and don't forget to like and subscribe to stay notified about our future videos. See ya!